Did you listen to Jeff and Professor Hemmo in the morning?
Here's what you missed.
Tasty Tuesday on the hottest breakfast show in all of Africa. Hashtag
Jeff and Hemmo on.
From the very shortest to the very tallest. Folks, coming up next, he's simply known as Tall. Superstar rugby player for Shujaa, Humphrey Kayange.
Oh, man.
Is in the house, I'm telling you, man. War man. Giving Tuesday.
Giving Tuesday.
Yeah. So give back.
Oh, yes.
And one person who has given back to this, to sporting in this world, especially rugby, is our guest today, man. I tell you, when you watch the highlights of Shujaa and as they play in the various teams and the various tournaments, Humphrey Kayange has been the man, cheering the team, playing the team, scoring tries, and representing this country at the highest level. By the way, he's just announced his retirement from professional rugby this year, and he's going to miss the World Cup next year. Ooh, shame. Humphrey, Tall, what's up?
What's up, Jeff?
I know you.
It's funny, eh? I mean, it was sweet the way it was short, eh?
Snap!
But you know, Elizabeth Marami is extra short. Extra short. But a lovely lady, eh?
Yes.
Super talented. Hmm? Oh my goodness. Well done, Elizabeth. Well, and you too, Humphrey, man. You have really, represented this country like no one would believe. In fact, you need to write a book one of these days on your experiences, what you've been through the last dozen years or so.
Yeah, I think so. I think for me, the last 13 years have been an incredible, amazing time. From the time I started looking back, I mean, I was just speaking to her more and saying, 13 years, everyone says 13 years is a long time. And first thing you ask, how do you last through all that? I think starting playing rugby in 2004 and just all the build up, you know, up to 2009 with the good performances and building that on up to 2016 where we won our first series. I think it's all worth it. It's all been a great learning experience for me, and the performances on the pitch have really made it all worthwhile.
Yeah. Like you say, 13 years, you know, because injuries, all kinds of things could hamper such a career, but man, you have done it all. What's been the highlight, Humphrey? Highlight of those 13 years?
I think the highlight will go with Singapore 20 that win.
Who can never forget? Who can never forget?
Early in my career, it was the semi-final win, the quarter-final win over Fiji in Dubai, which coming from where we are, from Kenya, and not being a big rugby powerhouse, and going out there and defeating the likes of Fiji in a quarter-final, that was really something that kept the fire burning in the boys, so to speak, and ensure they keep on working hard. But 2016, definitely top of the list for me.
And the fact that in the beginning, I'm sure nobody gave Kenya any chance when you first started out. And today, when the Shujaa marches on the field or jogs on the field, man, no matter where you are, by the way, it's not just Las Vegas or Kenya, I mean, there's a Kenyan corner in almost every stadium.
Yeah, I think the Kenyans have been really amazing at home and out there. You always say 43 million Kenyans, we don't count the ones out there, but there's a big, huge number of Kenyans. You'll see them out in places like Vegas and London where they have their own corner, they come to support the team, and which is really amazing. And for us, it all adds up into the tournament and into what we need to achieve.
Yeah. And the opponents now, do they give you more respect as a team, as Kenyans now?
Yeah, definitely. I think we pulled ourselves a seat at the table and joined dinner
with the big boys.
So just pass on the plate. So we earned the right to be there. So the main issue for us now is on how to stay there. You can sit at the table, but you need to contribute and you need to keep on your performances going on. So, yeah.
People always ask about the inconsistency sometimes of the Kenya Sevens. Huh? You have two great, you know, two, three runs, really, really doing well. And then the next time, boom, gone. Or you have a good Friday and a horrible Saturday, and you end up in your shield. The worst part is at the 13th place playoff.
that you see that comes from now how we picked up rugby. In terms of our training, our structures, we need to ensure the boys are on an almost similar platform as sort of big nations. So if you want to compete consistently against England, New Zealand, Fiji, the work you put in should be relatively the same as the work they put in. But we understand where we come from. I mean, back here, most of the boys are either students or they're working, and they're all over the place. Yeah. And the effort is not now centered towards professionalism and that. So it's an area that needs to change to get to start getting consistent performances. But for us, I mean, you still all over the place, but you're still getting your results. So that is something we can build on and ensure now for the next generation they're given the right structures, put in the right environment, so that we can get consistent performances. Again, 13th place. As a player, that is the worst place to be playing, because it's like you're number last, but you're not number last. You're fighting to be number last. With them. So it's the energy and motivation for that is quite a lot for you to do that.
And you know, many of you say, tunaonaga wakiwa kubwa hapa, wakienda huko wanasanga, Fijian, Mutuki, New Zealand. How do you go against the, unajua, naturally as a human being, kitu unaona, hii ni nyumba napigana na. How do you go about na uchape?
I think maybe that's the beauty of rugby, and Jeff, you played rugby before,
yes.
But you need to compete and,
and bring him down.
and bring you down. So it's a contact sport. You need to really back yourself out and compete on those places. So you'll meet people who are bigger, stronger than you.
Yes.
But the joy of it all is in how do you try and overcome and get them down and get a win over them.
By the way, the Fijians really respect you. You have a special relationship with the Fijians now, right? If they beat them or they beat you, you guys kneel down and pray afterwards? What's that about?
I think we always say Fijians came from Tanzania, so I think there's a it's historical.
Are you
I don't
serious?
Know. I think they say the Fijians, because in terms of how what we share in terms of our cultures, it's just the same. We meet up there jolly after the game. We all know there's a superior being, so we'll kneel down and say thank you to the Lord. And off the pitch, other interactions, they're just really genuine and happy people to be with. So that theory might be right. You just need to figure out how they got onto the to Fiji.
The sizes.
They eat a lot of fish here.
It's their meals too, eh?
Hamos.
Uku, Yeleri. Yeleri.
Nawaru.
All things constipation. Amo na chikuli una pereko arefiwe. Na pata sanaga.
Kimbia.
Kitu ina kimbia na niyako diobaya. Kitu ina kimbia inje. I mean, there was this generation. Ini wakati muli nyorosha. New Zealand. Imu kachapa South Africa. Imu kachapa. Everybody.
Yeah.
And looking back, do we still have such a generation? And where are we going now?
I think the interesting thing now is there's been that generation has sort of, the guys with that generation sort of stepping out and moving aside. Mm-hmm. Like this year, the team is heading out to Dubai today. I think.
Yeah, because the tournament's the weekend, right?
Yeah,
tournament begins on Friday.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you see now with the new technical bench and more than five or six young players onto the fray.
Yeah.
It means now we have to go back and start again. So those players, their goals, we shouldn't try and put those players on the same platform as that other group, because that other group took time to come together and gel and be a unit.
Yeah.
So for them, I'm sure they have the lessons to learn.
Mm-hmm.
They have sort of the targets, because if you are setting them up against a Singapore win, that's what they should do. In terms of performances, get a win and try and build their confidence.
Mm-hmm.
But it will take time. But I think they'll get there. For young players, it's really good, because I mean they still have the energy, they still have the drive. There's so much in front of them that you don't want to pin them down now. You want them to grow and learn. And some of the growth lessons will be painful, but it's a process.
What should we expect from this new season?
I think it's a turnaround season. This year might be an off season for us, and those are my thoughts. They might go out there and shock us,
sure.
But I think it will be an off season. Then picking up onto 2020 and the Olympics, I think they'll be getting there by that time. So just let them put their feet on the ground, settle down, learn the ropes. A few senior players in there will help them, but building up onto next year and the Olympics and the qualification process,
right.
That would be a good year for us.
Tell me something, when these other players who are, I think, literally all professionals in every country, they're all professional rugby players, when they hear that you guys have full-time jobs and rugby is just almost a pastime, are they shocked?
Yeah, it's really amazing. You speak to them all the time, and you like, I didn't get time off work, and I have to get back and quickly go and say hi to the boss before I'm fired on my next tour. And for them, they, since they come from a professional background, they do not, they will not understand that, and they will be like, this is really amazing. This for us, some of them will say, I can't do that. I'll either play, stop, then get into a professional job, but not do the two of them together. Mm. So I think Kenyans are really talented.
Yes.
you're competing on the same platform, but you're where you come from, it's, you're totally different. You're working, you're in school, and you have to train, you have to get the work done. So for them, they really look at us with a lot of respect on that front.
Niliona kuna baka academy ya rugby in South Africa. Mtu anapitia academy. Kila kitu unafanya, it's rugby. Na wewe ndio unakuja compete na yeye.
From the age of 5.
Na umetoka kuuza insurance. Unaona? Na bado unamnyorosha. You are truly shujaa.
Wengine wako kebs.
Ndio wako kebs.
Wako tupatia ile kidi.
Nilijua kutapona na comeback. Pali ulisema short. Hapo ndio nilijua
tayari. By the way, speaking of kebs, they have been very good to you, haven't they?
Yes, I've been really a very good boss in terms of the support on this front.
Correct.
Yeah, I've had my colleagues from other sectors where